And again, I know you've talked about this on your show. Again, Quincy, his own show on YouTube. You can Google it. Browns offensive line, is it still elite?
I think so. I think they're not the best anymore, right? They used to just be flat out the best by a significant margin. Other teams have caught up, but they are really good. Now, here's what could make them the best again. What if Nick Harris is better than J.C. Treader, right? That's what they're kind of betting on, right, that he's better. What if if Jedrick Wills takes that step from second to third that Wyatt Teller did, where Wyatt was a serviceable guard and then all of a sudden became the best guard in football or the best young guard in football next to Joel Bitonio? Okay, boom, you have the best offensive line in football by a significant margin. But if we're just projecting based on what players did in the years past, previous with those two young guys, then you have a pretty good offensive line. Also, we got to figure out the health of Jack Conklin. Came back from that pec injury way earlier than anybody expected him to. But Jack Conklin's ability to come back from injury has not been as big as an issue as him being injured, right? So we have to see what his status is there. And is James Hudson ready to take that role, right? If the Browns can sustain multiple hits on that offensive line and still maintain an elite level of play, that's a huge win for them.
How important is that going to be, especially if it's Jacoby Brissett as the quarterback? I mean, do you rely even more on the run game? And I mean, Jacoby Brissett's athletic. You can do some things with him game plan-wise and as a quarterback. How important is the line if it is Jacoby Brissett?
It becomes the most important thing on the team, right? That's what it transitions to. Everything's going to be on the offensive line. When Deshaun Watson's in there, everything would go through Deshaun Watson. Deshaun Watson's going to be the most important player on the offensive line, on the offensive side of the ball. That would be who would be most important. If he's not in there, it becomes the offensive line, because you're going to be able to run off the strength of the offensive line. And given the play action heavy schemes that the Browns like to run, you're going to be able to throw off of whatever the offensive line allows to develop, right? Again, you don't necessarily have the greatest wide receivers in the world, but you know what helps great, not great wide receiving play? Good offensive lines, because if you give a wide receiver 3 seconds to get open, they will get open given all the rules in the favor of the offensive side of the ball. So that's really what they're up against there.